Amazon Simple Email Service Tutorial. Before using Amazon Simple Email Service, you need to set up an account with the cloud computing platform. Once you have signed up or logged in, you can access your dashboard in AWS and search for Simple Email Services. You can find it under Verified Identifications. Next, you'll need to configure your domain name and verify its ownership. Once you've completed these steps, you can configure your app to use Amazon SES. Hello, and welcome to the Marketer DNA YouTube channel. Willy Desjarnet will navigate you through this video. First, he will discuss Amazon Simple Email Service Tutorial. Also, he will provide the site link at the bottom of the description.
Okay guys, before you go into the training, I would like to show you a lead capture system that has really grown my email list. It is called Lead Skimmer, and I have a link below. Look at my stats. And I'm gonna tell you this, look at this, 2,422 leads. Guys, let me tell you this. This actual lead capture page converts, guys. I'm just telling you, I wanna show you, let me just show you my inbox really quick. Look at there, Lead Skimmer. No matter where you market it, you will get leads coming into your system. All you gotta do is plug and play. All of this is a part of global MPN. So once you come in and join, and if you start to see emails from global MPN, this is the family. So go ahead and get you a Lead Skimmer account so you can start getting leads just like this really quick. I'll see you guys on the inside. What's going on, my friends? Tonight we want to go through a video training on how to just take your domain and run it through Amazon service, where when you have emails as far as an autoresponder, it can go through, because you have so many autoresponder and everybody running their emails through that autoresponder. That's why some of your emails end up being in a spam box. So the first thing you want to do is you're going to go to the Amazon service, AWS, and all you gotta do is go to Google, and we're gonna do it. Even though I already have it open, we're gonna go there and open it up so you can see it. And let's just go AWS, and it'll show up. It's part of a web server, but since we already have that up, that's all you guys have to type in. You have to type in that. So that's the first thing that you want to do. So let's go here, and this is what you want to do up here. Once you get in here and get your Amazon site, you're going to get here, and you have to type in just email, because it'll get you to where you need to go. And what you want to do, you want to go to the Amazon Simple Email Service. So now I have some domains already done. For some reason, this will never verify. But anyway, how you get started is, this is what you do. You want to create identity. So if you don't have anything with this, the first thing you want to do, you want to click here, and then you want to put your domain in there. And once you put your domain and you go on in there and sign it as the default setting, or use as a custom email domain, once you do that, you just click forward and create your identity. So that's really simple. Then you come back, and then, all right, we will use this, because this is already verified. So we'll come in here, and what you do is, once you get all of these tools set up in here, let's just move this baby along. Let's get this configuration here. Everything's successful. So now let's take a look at it. Everything's successful. Now what you want to do is, you want to get your configuration done. Let's get our configuration. Okay, there we go. Now this is something that you guys have to set up. If you have your email already on some kind of service, or your domain already connected to something like GoDaddy or Namecheap or things like that, you want to set these things here. Okay, let's just go to something that I already have set up. This is the Willy Desjarnet site. We're gonna go here to get us to where we're gonna go. And then you're gonna come down here, and where it says zone editors, and you see all these records? See all these records. This is what you're gonna do. CNAME. You're gonna put these in, let me get it over here. I apologize. You know, let's just go where we're managing all of them. Okay, you see right here, I just gonna show you these C names. You're gonna go in and put C names, but the best way to do it is, when they tell you what you need to do, you go C name, and then you can put it like, this is the name and you place it here, and then this is the value and you put, add a C name, you put the, let me make sure I'm telling you right, just trying to C name, name. Well, I'm telling you, it is very simple to do it this way, a lot simple. Let's just go ahead and do it the simple way. What you do, you come in here, and when you create one, you go right here and create what name you want to create. If you want to create add a CNAME record, you create a CNAME record. If you want to create a text one, you're going to create a text one. So this one's going to be a CNAME, but I already have that there. Once you get down here, here is your CNAME, and I'm going to show you what it's showing me. Right here, you have the name. This is... I'll just edit it so you can see it. That is the name right here, right here, right here. And then you have, we'll just move this over so it's right here. And then you have the value. You add all three of these entries in there. And then you have to download another record. And these two records will come down in a CSV file. And then you add those as well. And that will be two text name. And then you just go ahead and then you just hit, you go ahead and save it. That's what you do after you do that. You go ahead and save that. And that's down at the bottom. Let me move this over. You hit save records. So now the next thing that you do is we're going to go back and validate. We will validate these configurations. And let's just verify. Once you've done that, your domain to be verified. Now we're going to go back to the services, and then we're going to type in email again. It's just to get us back to where we were. Amazon services. Then we're going to validate the email. So, all right, now, just for training purposes, this is what we're going to do. We're going to create an email. We're going to create an email, and we'll come down. And this is just for training, guys. I just want to show you how you can add an email. And let's get down here where the emails are at. And we're going to create one. We're going to create training. We're going to just type in training. And then it's so long, slightly forgetting. We're going to go just for training. There we go. So the next thing we're going to do, we're going to create an email. And we're going to come back here and we're going to put that email address in there. Because see, we already have the domain there. And let's move this over. I don't think we have to add anything. Let's just go ahead and create the identity. Okay. Now let's just look at the verification. You see how that training at willydjournet.com already verified? The reason why that happened that way, because we've already have established the domain being verified. So you can come in and use these domains on any kind of system that you have, whether it's AWeber, GetResponse, and I use Mail Marketer Pro. And the reason why I use Mail Marketer Pro, for one price, you get unlimited amount of emails. On these all these other services, as you gain more email addresses, it costs you more to go up. So the reason why I'm saying this is when you go to your MailChimp, all these different autoresponders, what happened is so many people use that to where your emails will automatically end up eventually going into the spam folder. When you run it through Amazon SES, it's act as its own server on your own domain, and you don't have to run it on your domain, and it runs it through there, and then you have a better result when it comes to email marketing. But yeah, just go ahead and get you an Amazon SES account and run your domain through here, and then you walk through how you actually do this. So yeah, go ahead and check this out, guys. And if you have any questions on how I did it, what way I done it, it's very simple. You just walk right through and just pause the video and walk yourself through all this, and you'll be satisfied. But this is what I'm trying to teach people as far as being able to keep your stuff out of the spam folder. So guys, take care. And I hope that you like this video and subscribe to the channel.